Hey you guys, welcore back to Be More Light. You guys, I am back with another word, and this word is good, y'all. I've been just studying the word this morning, spending time with the Lord, and honestly, like, what he's putting in my spirit is just fresh revelation for all of us, and including myself. And so I love just spending this still time with God, because he really does pour into our hearts and into our spirits. He just gives us his revelation and his understanding, and this is what he means about, like, the mysteries of who he is. And so he wants to give us his insight, and when we plug our ears and tune into his voice and just remove ourselves from all distractions, and he really will come in and speak to us. And so let's pray and get right into this word. Father God, we thank you for today. We thank you for your power, your love, and your sound mind over our lives in this very hour. I pray, Father God, that under the sound of my voice, that you will speak through my lips like clay, and that I'm not relying on my own abilities, but standing and flowing through your supernatural wisdom, Lord, that you will get this word out to every single one of us, and that you will continue to confirm yourself to us in this hour. I pray for a deep revelation of your word, that it'll resonate in our spirits, that we will walk in it, Father God, and be doers of your word. In this hour, we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. So I actually went back to Matthew 13, and I read this yesterday and the day before. And so the Lord wants me here. And so I'm going to start off by reading a passage of scripture in Matthew 13, and please stay and listen to this word. I really encourage you to stay to, like, if maybe you're thinking of, like, starting this video or listening into it later on, just listen to it. And so the Holy Spirit wants to talk to you today. He wants to confirm to you today about his revelation, himself, his love for you. And so I'm going to start in Matthew 13:16. So, but blessed are your eyes because they see, and your ears because they hear. So here in this passage of scripture, God is literally referring to us listening and tuning in, which is what we're doing right now. 17, for truly I tell you, many prophets and righteous people longed to see what you see, but did not see it, and to hear what you hear, but did not hear it. Listen then to what the parable of the sower means. This is important, y'all. When anyone hears a message about the kingdom and does not understand it, the evil one, he's talking about Satan, the evil one comes and snatches it away, what was sown in their heart. This is the seed along the path. The seed falling on rocky ground refers to someone who hears the word and at once receives it with joy. But since they have no root, they quickly fall away. The seed falling among the thorns refers to someone who hears the word, but the worries of this life and the deceitfulness of wealth choke the word, making it unfruitful. But the seed falling on good soil, which is you and I, refers to someone who hears the word and understands it. This is the one who produces a crop, yielding 100, 60 or 30 times what was sown. And so as I was reading this, in each time as I was reading it, but more so today as I was reading it, I mean, like, when you think about what God is saying here, like, really unlayer it. And he's saying, when you hear his word, when you come into hearing his teachings and his prophecies, he wants you to not just hear it, he wants you to apply it, he wants you to walk in it, he wants you to yield to his word. Like, this, the Bible is our life. He is the way, the truth, and the life, and this is our instructions to get in by and walking out in our faith in the Lord. And so as he's talking about sowing, there's been moments where, and I could recollect in my life and recall in my life, moments where I heard the word of God. It was a good word. But as soon as I walked out of church, it didn't stick. It didn't resonate, because I didn't let the word just come in and consume me. I didn't let the Holy Spirit come in and do the work in me. I blocked him off. And so maybe this is something that you needed to hear today. Maybe you're hearing the word, but it's hard for you to apply the word. It's hard for you to even walk in a relationship with the Lord. Then I want to ask you this question today. How has God's word taken root in your life? And this is in my study Bible. This is a question in my study Bible. What kind of soil are you? this is the parable of the soils, and I really encourage you to go back and start Matthew 13, because Jesus talks about the four soils. So out of these four soils, let me go back. The four soils, I'm going to try and like go, you know, through them. So he said it right here. I mean, he said pretty much the seed along the path, when anyone hears the message about the kingdom and does not understand it, the evil one comes and snatches away what was sown in their heart. This is the seed along the path. This is the first one. The seed falling on rocky ground refers to someone who hears the word and at once receives it with joy. But there's no root, so it doesn't stick. It doesn't hold, like, you're not holding on to anything. You receive it in joy, like, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Holy Spirit. This is so good. You're praising the Lord in it, but then you don't see the fruits of it because you didn't allow it to take root in your heart, in your life. And he says it lasts only a short time. Number three, when trouble or persecution comes because of the word, they quickly fall away. The seed falling among the thorns, this is three, refers to someone who hears the word, but the worries of this life and the deceitfulness of wealth choke the word, making it unfruitful. Here, the biggest key word right here is wealth. It says wealth, the love of money, you know, to love money, to love the things of this world. It chokes you up. It chokes the word right out of you, making you unfruitful, making the Lord unfruitful, meaning the Lord can't work in your life because you're distracted by the pleasures of the world. That's three. Four is where we are in, where we want to be in. He says, but the seed falling on good soil refers to someone who hears the word and understands it. This is the one who produces a crop yielding 160 or 30 times what was sown. I'm going to open up my computer really quickly, and I'm going to find the definition to... Oh, I'm so sorry, guys. Like, I'm trying. To good soil. So, let me look this up really quickly. Really, no internet? Sometimes the internet's a little slow here, so let's see. Okay. We're gonna see what good soil means in the Bible, y'all. I could do it from my Bible, but it's much faster on the internet. So, let's see. Good soil represents people who hear the message and live it in their lives. Some people have strong faith and remain dedicated to a Christian lifestyle even when things are difficult. That is so spot on, y'all. That is so well written. Think of it this way. You're walking this faith walk out, right? It's you and the Lord. You're walking this faith walk out with God. And maybe you are the only one in your family. Maybe you're the only one in your family that is, you know, really having a meaningful relationship with the Lord. And the thing is, sometimes God will raise one up in the family because someone has to change the dynamic, break the generational curse. And that's a word for a different day. And so, but you're walking this walk out, you know, and God says the road that leads to destruction is very broad. Many people are on it. That's the easy way out, to do what everybody else is doing, to follow the rest of the world. But the road that leads to heaven, to God, is very narrow. He says it's difficult. This is a hard road to be on. It's worth it, absolutely. But it's difficult because you have persecution. You have so many things, outlets. You have the way the world is going, everyone's against you. The world doesn't like us because not only is it the truth that the Lord is allowing us to step into, be set free in, but the enemy doesn't want the truth to be exposed, because if his time is short, he knows where he's ending up. He knows where he's going, and he's trying to take as many people as he can. And so this is why it's important to know what soil you are sowing into. If you want to be a good sower, if you want to be a cheerful giver, if you want to be someone who's walking holy and righteous in the Lord, even if you're trying, even if you are praying and asking the Lord to redeem you, to strengthen you, because this walk is not easy. I do not make light of that. I say it's worth it. Absolutely. Where I used to be at, I don't want to go back there. And so when I saw, and I talk about this all the time on this channel, how good and faithful the Lord is, I ain't going back. I'm not going back. So that is my redemption and my salvation. It is a gift of the Lord. And so I want to share this with you guys today, because maybe the fruits in your life haven't been producing crops of 100, 60, or 30 times what was sown because of your belief, because of your faith in the Lord. Maybe you're not wanting to give up certain things. Maybe you're not wanting to let go of that relationship that God's been telling you to let go of because it's not producing any fruit in your life, any goodness. If anything, is taking you back into the world. Maybe God has called you out of a certain job position, but because of your lack of faith, because you're holding on to the thought process of, this is how I provide for my family. This is my means to provide. But don't we know that God tells us he supplies all of our needs according to his riches and glory? And I'm telling you guys, I am a firm believer. My testimony is that when God called me to quit my job and quit school to follow him, it didn't make sense. It didn't make sense. Over a course of a few weeks, he was putting it in my spirit out of obedience. And I did it out of obedience. And I was scared. I did it out of obedience. But then he showed up in my life in ways that man could never do it, ways that I couldn't do it. And so I'm a firm believer that when you don't know, God knows. You have to trust him. This is what it means to sow in good soil. Let your seeds fall on good soil. Plant in good soil. Do not plant your seeds and take them back out. That's why you're not seeing any crops. You're not seeing any fruits of what you've been planting. So God wants you to plant your seeds. If you want your seeds to take root, surrender it to the Lord. Whatever it is that's been weighing in your heart, that maybe you have worries about, maybe it's hard for you to give up, maybe it's been an addiction in your life, whatever the case may be, trust God to give it unto him so that you can take on his strength. He says, for he literally trades the things that we go through, our weights, for his yoke. His yoke is light. So cast all your cares onto the Lord. Cast all your weights, all your cares onto him, and he will supply for you. Whatever it is you need, is the strength that you need today, he will give it to you. Is it joy because you've just been so unhappy? Give him those very things that are hurting you. Let go of the rope that is burning your hands. And let the Lord come in to heal you. He says, 22, Matthew 13, 22, the seed falling among the thorns. If this sounds like you today, I want to describe what this sounds from a different perspective to you. The seed falling among the thorns refers to someone who hears the word. You're hearing the word, but the worries of this life and the deceitfulness of wealth choke the word, making it unfruitful. And wealth could mean money. Maybe you're putting your plans in money and this and that, and you're making your own plans. But God says, many are the plans in a man's heart, but it is the purpose of God that prevails. See, God has purpose for your life over your plans. Our plans can never amount to what God is doing. He does it supernatural. He does it above and beyond. He literally is the head and not the tail. He is literally seated on his throne, you guys. And so I want to encourage you guys with this word. If you want to produce a crop yielding 160 or 30 times what was sown, because God could do it. God could do all things. And if this is something you are wanting, you are needing, then surrender to the Lord. Whatever it is that's been weighing you down, whatever distractions have been keeping you from him, maybe you've been distant from him, maybe you've been just in a place where you feel like you don't hear his voice, I encourage you today, whatever is distracting you in this hour, you will know. He will place it in your heart. He will place it in your spirit. You will know that very thing that maybe you've been crying about, that you've been just so unhappy and you've been feeling as though it's just taking you away from the love of Christ. Give that, let it go. Give it to him. This is your message today, to let it go. Let the Lord come in and allow him to do a work in you so that you can come out on the other side as his child, as a kingdom child. That's what he has for you. He has so much better in store. And it's this path is not easy, but he promises to be with us. He says he will never leave you and he will never forsake you. Do not be dismayed. Do not fret and be dismayed. He is your God. We serve a big God, you guys. Trust him in being God in your life. And I promise you, when you trust him and do the work of diligence and consistency and consecration and fasting and praying and worshiping, none of that goes unnoticed. But you know what? When I started to really surrender my ways to the Lord, that was the best thing I ever did, because I don't know anything without the Lord. He knows everything. He knows the plans for our life. Jeremiah 29:11, for I know the plans I have for you, plans to prosper you, plans to give you hope and a future. His plans are never to harm us. So if you feel you're feeling harm and you're feeling trauma and just experiences that you are wanting to get out of, give those experiences to God. Give those very things to the Lord. Resist the enemy and he will flee y'all. He is out here trying to take whoever he can, trying to steal, he's trying to kill your hopes, your dreams. He's trying to steal away the very word of God. He talks about it right here in the parable of the four soils. If he could take away that very word within you, he's doing his job. But we have the authority to stand in place and stand in faith and to call him out. He's a liar. He is not going to win. This battle has already been won by the Lord. God has come to, he's already overcome the world. So imagine that promise you can stand on, that the Lord has overcome the world. Amen. And so I want to encourage you guys with this word. This word was much longer, but I felt as though I needed to share this. I felt led to share this, and I pray that it encourage you guys, and that this word is a revelation to you, and that it penetrates in your spirit. Let it just come in and resonate you, and just let the Lord come in and speak to you and do that good work in you. It is worth it, you guys. I love you guys so much, and I'll talk to you guys soon.